Hi, I'm Daryl R. Hall, and this is From the Vault.
So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to
today's
the
movie,
lobby.
The Roaring Twenties. The Roaring Twenties is at once the last gangster film of the 1930s and probably one of the better examples of its genre. The film stars James Cagney as Eddie Bartlett, a World War I hero coming back from the trenches. Quickly, he finds getting his old job back, or any job for that matter, is increasingly difficult for anybody coming back home.
Back too. I'll bet it is. What are you going to do?
Oh, rest up a couple of days, see a few of the boys, and I'll be ready to go to work.
That's fine. What are you going to do? Where are you going to work?
Hmm? What do you mean, where am I going to work? I was going to come back here.
Well, I'm sorry, Eddie. I haven't anything for you.
What?
This country, and making money becomes a major issue.
Overseas begin to find out that the world has moved on during the time they spent in France.
Sorry, buddy. Nothing doing.
Eddie mistakenly goes into a speakeasy one day and unfortunately gets picked up for a bum bootlegging run.
Honey, I don't know what's in the package and I don't care. $12, please.
Quit raising
just
your motor.
Just a minute. You bootleggers are going to learn that the law is being enforced.
What are you talking about?
This is when he meets Panama Smith, played fabulously by Gladys George.
Get out of here.
Hey, Buster, who do you know?
I know a lawyer.
Be better if you knew a judge.
He goes to jail, and she sets his bail. They form a quick friendship, and eventually he builds a criminal empire of bootlegging.
That was born of a marriage between an unpopular law and an unwilling public. Liquor is the password in this army, and it's a magic password.
He becomes pretty good at it, makes an enterprise, even enlisting some of his friends from the war, such as attorney Lloyd Hart, played here by the great Jeffrey Lynn.
Now, wait a minute, Eddie. This is too much for what I did. Buying a couple of taxicabs for you doesn't rate this kind of money.
Oh, you saved me dough. Take it. That's just a beginner. You hang on to my shirt tails and you'll be using that for wallpaper.
He even partners with other bootleggers, such as the cold-hearted George Haley. Play here win the rock-solid performance by Humphrey Bogart.
No, but he looks like a kid about 15 years old.
He won't be 16.
Things end up going so wonderfully for Eddie that he even gets a love interest in Gene Sherman. Played here by Priscilla Lane.
I've had a wonderful time.
Hey, it's kind of a quick brush off, ain't it?
What do you mean?
Well, it's a long trip to Mineola, and I kind of like to relax between trains.
It's 4 o'clock in the
morning. Certainly have learned all the answers.
Well, you seem to know all the questions. I'll send it
right. However, Jean is not in love with Eddie, and she ends up falling for his attorney, Lloyd Hart.
Our legal brain. If ever you want to sue anybody, see him. Gene Sherman.
How do you do?
Hello?
After that, his life becomes a series of bad luck, eventually leading to the end of Prohibition and the fall of his empire.
Well, happy New Year.
The Roaring Twenties has a wonderful cast, led by Cagney, and a very strong performance from character actress Gladys George as Panama Smith. Cagney, however, really steals the show, giving us one of his greatest performances.
I know what's bothering you. Maybe Panama was right. Maybe you and me don't play in the same league. Hey, that's it. You don't like the racket I'm in, you don't like the people I know, the things I do.
The film was directed by Raoul Walsh, who also directed Cagney in 1949, 10 years later, of course, in White Heat. Walsh was a longtime Warner Brothers mainstay, doing films such as Colorado Territory and High Sierra. With The Roaring Twenties, Raoul Walsh gives us one of his great directorial outings. The Roaring Twenties is a great example of social commentary mixed with hard-nosed, action-packed melodrama. If you guys haven't seen it already, I really suggest checking it out. Until next time, this is From the Vault.
He used to be a big shot.